Have you ever wanted to combine every Rimworld ideology? On paper, that seems like a pretty good idea. But having recorded this video, I can tell you there's a reason I named our faction Hell, and it has something to do with this disgusting mess. I'm the Grim Cleeper, and I've combined every single Rimworld ideology into one super ideology, where our people only eat meat, but prohibit killing animals. And where we love to live underground and eat fungus, but mining is illegal. Not to mention the fact that I somehow have 4 moral leaders and about 30 different rituals, but we'll ignore that. So immediately upon starting, and I already want to die. Not to mention the fact that we have 12 different rituals expected, and all of our colonists are blind. So I made the beginnings of our base, but it looks like we have a raid, which is fantastic because our colonists are more incompetent than an Amish drive-by. So trying to recruit someone would be they're dead. So something that I hadn't really thought about before making this ideology, besides the fact that I like to have fun when I play RimWorld, is that while trading and charity are essential, we're also raiding fanatics that worship death. We're playing some 4D chess here, I don't know what's going on. The only good part of this colony is that they like dying, which is something they're probably gonna do very often. So unsurprisingly, I haven't really been paying attention to the needs of our colonists, and looking at them already, it's a little frightening. But our mood is really high, mostly because they're just chugging human meat and blind.
Oh god, you've gotta be kidding me.
So we walked inside for just a second because I figured out the Wolverine would lose aggro and now I want to shoot it, but of course I forgot. We can't. And I feel like this is an appropriate name for our faction and community. Welcome to Hell, Hell, Hell. Visitors, oh please have a good ideology. And no, they are just as stupid as we are. He recently traded with someone, we're gonna be rich. Half a brain cell tells me no. You know, this might not be as bad as I thought. I'm looking at our mood buffs and this person was mid-tending on a prisoner and they died. And somehow that gives us a plus 20 mood buff. Ethical festival expected. Our faction name is Hell and you've named our festivals Ethical. That's either deeply concerning or a big relief. Or maybe it's demonic because we've possessed the stone block apparently.
Oh no, the Mega Wolverine is back and violence all the ways across the map.
It's literally hunting you and you refuse to shoot it. Okay, we're not really off to the best start, are we? Oh my god.
Minus 32 mood.
8 non-meat. Minus another 8 for non-cannibal food. It's minus 40.
I do not know how we're gonna survive. And after fighting off an infection, PG is now somewhat ugly and repels others during social interactions.
Damn, I didn't know I'd make a cameo in this. So we've enslaved our first person, which is fantastic, because most of our people can't do anything. Did I say only our people aren't useful? Yeah, I take that back. So we got the fleeing knight quest, and you know, the typical quest, yada yada. This is a charity quest. If you don't fulfill it, believers in hell will be unhappy due to their charitable beliefs. I always knew that Satan was just a misunderstood, upstanding guy. Our mood list is such a roller coaster. We have unforgettable festival, blind, ate human meat, noble helped, enslaved prisoner, ate non-meat, ate non-fungus, ate non-cannibal, uncovered body part, no ocular trees, and too long outdoors. I'm honestly surprised we made it 8 days. And right as I say that, our guy is trying to escape.
And his reward is that we're gonna be removing his leg.
Kind of. In a very creative sort of way. Honestly, better than what I expected considering our surgeon is blind. Or kill him from blood loss. I guess that works too. At least someone's happy about this.
Oh no, I have 4 religious roles unfilled and we only have 3 colonists. It's a minus 20 moon buff.
This is why you don't have 4 moral guides. Crisis of belief. Yeah, it's about time you realized your religion is like being the sacrifice at a satanic ritual. I mean, I'm all for religious acceptance, but no, wait, this is RimWorld, screw that. So a bunch of thugs are calling us for a protection fee. But like, condoms aren't that expensive, right? And they're happy that we said no. Why did you ask in the first place? You know, it didn't take very long for the whole we're gonna be rich mindset to turn into we're a failure. Yeah, maybe we should have just started with that. So I built a research bench thinking that, you know, we could research batteries or something. And then I remembered. Right. we're basically the 15th century Catholic Church. I think the saddest thing about our ideology is that the only way for me to get steel is to deconstruct these walls, because our colonists will get a minus 40 mood debuff if someone breaks a block. Yeah, that's kind of bad. Well, isn't that just Peachy? The best part is that Peachy is our most armored colonist with the plasteel helmet and the flak vest. And because of that, I've been kiting her for like 5 minutes. Something tells me that at least someone in this colony is gonna die. On the bright side, Peachy got bulldozed by a local moose, so that's helpful, I guess. The only reason that no one's died is because I keep switching Eden's role between our moral leader and a medical specialist, just so that I can avoid the minus 30 mood debuff from lost academic role. Lamb's salvation. Prisoner being held by the Orange Bluff bandits stole a radio, with the camp being near hell. How am I gonna get there? The rapture? Achievement unlocked. Have a 5% average mood in the colony. I'm honestly surprised it's not 0% at this point. I take that back. It is 0%. So we got the Ship to the Stars quest. And honestly, considering the fact that we can't do research, I think we just have to go here. And you know what? That's our new goal. So we've been traveling for like 6 seconds, and most of our people have already been down from hypothermia. Turns out traveling in the winter, in a tundra biome, at night, is not really a good idea. Oh my gosh, our savior, we got a man in black. And there goes Peachy. And we've lost villain too, and holy crap, look at how many notifications are on the side. I can't even see what notification this is. Lynx is hunting Eden for, oh no. So it looks like it's a, oh, wait, what? We have a second man in black. Come on, Cal, you're our last hope. No, we lost our last person. And to think it was all so promising.
Shoop. If you liked the video, obliterate the like and subscribe buttons. Also, check out my Twitch, where I stream Rimworld and the KFC Dating Simulator. Thanks for watching. See you.